Good afternoon all. I'm Hafiz, a 6th student of Vedivyas Institute of Technology. Hereby let me begin the 7th day of workshop conducted by Department of Civil Engineering in association with ICIVIT chapter. Let me heartily welcome our speaker, Engineer Dhanya KK, Senior Manager of Infra Project Department, Cochin Shipyard Limited. She has been worked in Cochin Shipyard Limited since 2005 and has more than 15 years of experience in construction field. She completed her UG and PG programs from USAC. Welcome ma'am. Now let me happy welcome each and every participant and faculty members who joined in this section. Now may I thanks each and every crew members of ICIVIT chapter for experiencing this wonderful opportunity. So may I now hand over this section for our speaker, Dhanya ma'am. Ma'am, please.
Thank you Happy for your introduction. At this venture, I would like to thank Vedavyasa Engineering College, all associate members, and especially Divya, HOD Civil Engineering Department, Mr. Sajid, ICA Chapter Secretary, Kozhikode, to invite me to and give me an opportunity to take this webinar. Also, let me thank Cochin Shipyard Management Team for permitting me to take this webinar. Prima facie, I appreciate Vedavyasa Engineering College Civil Department and ICA chapter for conducting this webinar for through the last 7 days through various subjects in the field of civil engineering. The effort of bringing together all students, teachers, and professionals in one platform is a welcome step. So today I would like to share my experience on modern marine infrastructures. I'm also sharing a case study of how Keywall works. This Keywall was executed in Cochin Shipyard Limited during the year 2013. So all of you must have heard about the marine assets. What is meant by marine assets? Marine assets means shiplift, dry dock, keywall, slipway, wharf, that is going on. All marine assets is become the integral part of any shipbuilding or ship repair industry. It is an integral part of port harbor. Without these marine assets, the shipbuilding industry or ship repair industry or port can't perform well. So before going to the presentation, I would like to have a brief about Cochin Shipyard Limited, my company. So Cochin Shipyard Limited is at Kochi, that is close to the Cochin Port Trust and the Southern Naval Command. Cochin Shipyard has a turnover of more than 3,000 crores and it is a consistently profit-making company for the last 22 years. So Cochin Shipyard, why Cochin Shipyard is at Kochi? So coming to our topic, marine infrastructure. Marine infrastructure is divided into two. For the berthing one and other one is repairs bar maintenance. Marine infrastructure, first we are moving to the berthing of a ship. For a berthing of a ship, a keywall or a jetty or a wharf is a mandatory thing. And in the keywall, jetty and wharf, following services are also required. Following services means dolphin, bollard, fender, buoy, pontoon, crane, power, air, industrial gases and water. So the keywall. Keywall, what is meant by keywall? Keywall is a retaining structure which is having in front of the keywall water pressure is there and behind the keywall earth pressure is there. So this keywall is a retaining wall to resist the water pressure and the earth pressure. So if the ship is berthing, please assume if the ship is berthing without a keywall, then what it happens? So there is not retaining wall. Then what is the issue is that ship is having a some draft. That is some part of the ship is sinking into the water. So around 2 to 4 meter or 2 to 7 meter like that, that portion is dipped into the water. So that much draft is there. So if in the in front of the keywall, if keywall is no retaining wall is there, then that area is in the water is fully slushy and is fully filled with sand or clay. So this sand or clay is to be removed, then only ship can able to berth. So at that time dredging is required. If proper dredging is to be done, then a keywall is a mandatory, then any retaining structure is a mandatory. That's why the keywall is having some importance. And jetty is also the same. I will show the photographs in the coming slide so you can get more clarity on that. It is a projected structure. Keewal is in the alignment of the shipyard. And the wharf is also the same, but wharf is normally the same keewal, but say keewal is operated in the port trust, then it is calling as wharf. That is the only difference. Then coming to services. Services is dolphin, bollard and beach. These three things are more or less the same. Bollard is mainly used for tying or mooring operation. That is, if vessel is coming, the vessel is tied to the bollard. Dolphin is the same thing, but the only difference is that dolphin is in the independent bollard. Is normally this dolphin is come across in the offshore structures. It is mainly used for the tying the ship. The fender. Fender is a thing which is connected between the key. It is a rubber fender. It is connected between the keewal. It is fixed in the keewal. So fender is, if ship is coming, ship is not hitting the keewal because of the presence of the fender. So fender protects the keewal from hitting the ship. So ship also protected. This is coming to the next thing is coming to the buoy. Buoy is a navigation marker. If buoy is there, then a vessel captain is knowing the route. If he is having buoy, then he understands that some obstruction is there, some mooring operation is there, or something is there. So he reroute the path. Then coming to the pontoon. Pontoon is a floating structure with some buoyancy tanks are there. Buoyancy tanks in the sense there are on four numbers of buoyancy tank like that. The buoyancy tank water is filled in it. Then this buoyancy tank, then the ship or this pontoon sinks in it. And after that water is pumping out, we can do the underwater repairs. And coming to the cranes. Crane is that the transportation purpose crane is using. Lot of inbuilt cranes are there and mobile cranes also there. This is crane mainly used for taking the material from one area to the other area. To the other area means to the ship. Shifting some material to the ship, the crane is required. Next, coming to the power. Air, compressed air and industrial gases, that is oxygen, carbon dioxide, argon, then water. These all are the requirements to the, these all things are feeding to the ship. For that, power is a separate duct. So cable trench, one trench is required. This is cable trench and these all are in the service trench. So two service lines are to be given to the ship through the quayside. Now coming to, so berthing, I think you have understood the keewal, jetty, wharf, etc. And coming to underwater repair, if ship is coming for berthing, then this side is okay. If the ship is coming for an underwater repair, then we need a dry dock or ship lift or slipway. So for all these things, I will detail in the coming slides. Now coming to the shop floor. Shop floor means shop, lot of shops are in the shipyard for the construction of the ship units, all those things. For that, process equipment, that is in the shop, lot of equipments are there, plate cutting equipments, because once hull length steel is coming, that plate is cutted and making a ship unit. So process equipment and civil work. Civil work is that shop floor construction and shop foundation is there and shop superstructure is there. All those things are in this area. Next, coming to the, I am detailing all those things through the photographs so you can more clear about that. This is the keewal. This one is the keewal. The person standing on the keewal. And this is the bollard. This is a small pontoon. It is for moving purpose from this area to this boat. Then some small area we are using this pontoon. This is the bollard. I told you about the draft in the ship. We have marked the draft in this direction. So some drafts around 4 meter like that for this ship is under the water. That's why here dredging is required. For dredging, then water pressure resistance, we are using the called retaining wall, that called as keewal. Here also another bollard. This is a small bollard. Jetty. Jetty is a narrow structure projecting from the shore. This is the shoreline. This is projecting into the water with boats. So vessel here we can able to park. Here also we can able to park. Jetties are provided at the places where harbor entrance is affected by littoral drift or the sea is shallow for a long distance. Jetties extend from the shore to the deep sea to receive the ship. Now coming to the dolphin. Dolphin is a man-made structure. I told you for mooring operation for we are using the dolphin. This is in the offshore structure. This is the independent thing. Now coming to the bollard, fender, buoy, pontoon. So bollard. This is the bollard and this is the fender. Bollard is a sturdy, short, vertical post on a ship or quay used for mooring of the vessel. This one is the bollard. This is the fender. I told you for protecting the ship hit to the quay wall, we are using the fender. The fender is used to absorb the kinetic energy of the vessel or a boat berthing against a quay. Now coming to buoy. Buoy is an anchored float that serves as a navigation mark or for mooring. This is a if it is seen, then it is a navigation mark, we can understand. Then pontoon. Pontoon is a flat bed floating vessels used to add buoyancy to a structure. Buoyancy to be done, then some floating buoyancy tanks are there, then water is filling, then it is down and water is ejecting, then it is floated. Like water is pumping out, then it is floated and we can do the underwater works here. Then coming to the dry dock, that is for a underwater repair, we need a dry dock or a slipway or a ship lift. So coming to the first, coming to the dry dock. Dry dock, the main heart of the dry dock is the dock wall. You can see the dock wall. And I will explain first the dock wall. Dock wall is made up of a sheet pile structure. In CSL, we have been had two dry docks and two dry docks are all of sheet pile structure. And other third one is also we are making, that is also a sheet pile structure. Then this sheet pile structure is not a cantilever one. This is anchored to the a anchor wall, which is behind a 25 or 35 meter apart. And this anchor wall and this sheet pile wall is anchored with a tie rod. That all those things I will show in the case study. Same quay wall construction, also same principle is followed. Some areas they are using instead of sheet pile walls, some areas, some docks we are using diaphragm walls also. The diaphragm wall is a concrete wall. That is, we are digging a trench and filling with concrete like that. So here steel, diaphragm wall, concrete. Then next coming to the dock floor. Next main ingredient is the dock floor. Please note that ship is not resting on the dock floor. Ship is resting on a keel block and then this load, keel block load is transferred to the dock floor. This is the principle of the docking method. Dock floor is made up of RCC piles at a distance of around 3 meter or 2 meter apart in both the directions. Next coming to the three parts. Over next coming to a gate. Its main component is the gate. This gate is of different types. Removable type is there. Flap gate, that is it is putting into a this plat one pit. Hinge type is there and caisson type is also there. If the span is increasing, then caisson type is the best one. Caisson type means water is filling, then it is sinking. Water is pumping out, we can move out to the here this area to other area and vessel is undocked and then we can put again gate. That is the method. For gate, one sill is there. Gate is resting on a sill. Sill means above the dock floor a concrete floor is there. Above the dock floor a concrete 1 meter or 0.5 meter projection is there. So what is the difference between a graving dry dock and a floating dry dock? Normally in the interviews, we are asking the same question. That's why I thought to put it in slide. Graving dry dock is what I told is the graving dry dock. It's a type of dry dock that is a large pit in the ground separated from a waterway. That is large pit means this is the ground level and we are making a large pit by excavation and then sheet pile driving and for dock floor making also. So large pit vessel is sitting and it is separated from a waterway by a gate as I shown in the earlier slide. Once the ship enters the graving dock, the gate is shut and all water pumped out, leaving the vessel dry so that underwater work can be done. Coming to the floating dry dock. Floating dry dock is a type of pontoon for dock shipping possessing floodable buoyancy chambers as U-shaped cross section. This is the U-shaped cross section. Right now, when water is pumped out stage, right now, water is this situation is the water is pumped out stage. When water is pumped out of the chamber, dry dock rises and ship is lifted out of the water. This is the ship is lifted out of the water and we can do the repair right now. While ship is moving to the water, then water is filled into it. Then this floor is moved down and ship can move to this water. Now coming to the ship lift. Ship lift is also main purpose, same dock's purpose, ship lift also serving. Ship lift is used to dry dock and launch ships. It consists of a structural platform. This is the structural platform and these are the trestles. You can see that this green color thing are the trestles and these are the winches. Ship lift consists of two things, ship lift system and a transfer system. So ship lift system, this platform, right now this picture is on, ship lift is raised to the ground level. This platform already hanged through the winches at the bottom. At that time, ship enters. Then this platform is raised to the top through the winches and this trestles also moved up. Then this is the transfer system. A power pack also there. This transfer system is moving the ship lift through these rails to the workstations. In the dry dock keel blocks, we have seen in ship lift, instead of keel blocks, these are the trestles. Same ship lift and a dry dock, same purpose, but one have ship dry dock is having a digged pit and inside dry and it is work, that's one place. But in ship lift, we can taken through the ship lift and we can place the vessel in any concrete surface area and do the repair. That is the main difference. I will explain more in the coming slide. As I told, this is the platform. This is the ship. This is the winches. You can see the hanging wire from the winch. This is hanging. This platform is hanging. So this is the ship. So platform, trestle, and we can move the platform after entering the ship. We can move the platform up and the trestle is contacted with the ship and all the load is transferred to the ship. And after that, through the winches, this platform is moving to the top. This is the top portion. Then next thing is coming, that is ship lift part is over. Then next thing is transfer system. So some bogies is, this is the trestle, this trestle after from the moving to the top, this is the trestle. Under the trestle, these bogies are coming, these bogies, and this is the trolley with a power pack moving through the rails. They're moving through the rails and moving to the workstation. That is the principle of ship lift. I hope that you have understand the ship lift operation. In the ship lift operation, lot of this electrical, mechanical and control things is a practical activity. In dry dock and ship lift, most of the cases, 70-80% of civil works and 20% is the mechanical, electrical and control work. Here this control works is a tedious thing, and if any automation is not working, then ship lift having the trouble. Now coming to slipway. Slipway, you might have seen normally, it is a ramp or a launch on the shore by which ships or boats can be moved to and through from the water. And as I told, last thing is the shop floor. Shop floor is that, this is the one picture of the shop floor. Superstructure is there. Dock floor is there. It's not dock floor, shop floor is there. And lot of equipments, the plate cutting equipments, etc. is coming. And I told you, we are using this place, we are making a unit like this. We can see that one unit is coming like this. We are making a lot of units and then the dock. So around marine infrastructure, I had some brief. Now moving to the construction of quay wall for berthing ships. So I am taking this seminar for case study for berthing ship, how quay wall is made. So I am moving to the case study. So this is the aerial view of the Cochin shipyard. Right now I told you around 498 meter Q1 is there and 460 meter Q3 is there. Now the extension is happening to 170 meter. This shipyard area is total in the around of sprawling in its 72 acres of campus. And this, apart from these dukes, this total key length is coming to around 1.2 kilometer. So this case study is this extension of 170 meter. 170 meter key wall, apart from this 170 meter key wall, a crane track is extending from to a length of 270 meter. Also, the service trench and cable trenches extending to up to the 270 meter. Crane track is extending in the existing quay wall, also in the existing quay wall and also in the new quay wall. This is the construction site before the commencement of work. What exactly is this project? That is, I told you the this quay wall is at the southern end, this extension. Other key one, key two, and before the extension, all are done in 1975. Now 2030, we have done the key wall extension. So 170 meter key wall extension and crane track, I told you 270 meter, service trenches and cable trenches extension 285 meter. Then deepening of the berth channel, as I earlier told that a dredging is requirement. Then this is the dredging. Now coming to the installation of bollard, fender, anode and associate infrastructures. Now coming to the typical section of quay wall. This is, I am explaining each and every point. You please go deeply in it, otherwise you will not understand correctly. So first I am moving to the quay wall main ingredient, that is sheet pile. The dock wall also like dock wall, quay wall, this is the sheet pile. We have driven a sheet pile of around 24 meter. This is the sheet pile wall. This is AZ section. I told you this. I will show the pictures of sheet pile in the coming slides. This sheet pile is of high section modulus thing. So high section modulus, this much high section modulus, it's not available in India, and we have imported from Luxembourg, Germany, Luxembourg, Europe. Sorry. This is the sheet pile, and after the sheet pile, we can see the anchor wall. This is the anchor wall. This anchor wall is a concrete wall. This we are normally telling that dead man. This is the dead man. So this anchor wall is around 4.5 meter depth and around 2 meter width, a anchor wall. Due to the pressure of the quay wall and this quay wall, this sheet pile wall and this anchor wall is tied with the help of a tie rod. It's a steel section tie rod. It's only having 52 mm or 60 mm or 72 mm. That is the diameter of the tie rod. This is a four pieces, one joint here. This is the ring joint and here the turnbuckle. Here also another joint. So four pieces it is coming. And in front of the sheet pile, a bailing channel is there. Bailing channel is mainly used for aligning the sheet pile. This is the channel, two channels is placed, aligning the sheet pile. This bailing channel normally used for, after sheet pile driving, this bailing channel is fixing. So this bailing channel is uniformly distributing the load to the anchor wall. So I think, and one more thing I want to explain, that this anchor wall is normally having the tendency to move to this side because of the sheet pile, because of the water pressure here. This is because here water pressure is higher comparing to the earth pressure. For that, for getting the passive resistance to the anchor wall, we are introducing a soling stone up to this area and up to this area. Then in the top, we are gunniting. So for placing anchor wall in position, we are giving passive resistance to the anchor wall. We are giving this soling stone. Now coming to, so for the key wall and above the sheet pail wall, a coping beam is there. This is the coping beam, 3 meter height, a coping beam. So below that sheet pail is alone, and here one concrete coping is there. In that picture you can see one man is standing here. So the main features of the key wall is, and one more thing, the key wall means spelling is Q-U-A-Y, but we pronounce it as key, not quay. And for the key wall, so sheet pail wall, anchor wall, tie rod, and coping beam, veiling channel. These are the main things. And these are two anodes we are fixing for preventing the corrosion to the sheet pail wall, because sheet pail is the steel member, so it's having a tendency to corrode. So for preventing the corrosion, we are placing anode. Okay, then coming to this, these are the fenders we have seen, and this is the bit we have seen, the all under services, and here piping duct, here cable duct. Piping duct means service duct, service lines in this duct we are giving, and here cable duct we are giving the cables for giving the electricity to the ship. Now coming to the crane track, I told you apart from the key wall extension, a crane track extension is also there, because without crane we can't able to ship the materials to the ship. So this is the one crane rail, and this is the other crane rail. Crane rail is supported on the piles, 650 mm dia piles, and after that crane beam is also there. This is the crane beam. Then after the crane beam, then a tie break between two beams, a tie beam is there. Under the tie beam also small pile is there. This is 500 mm dia pile, here 650 mm dia main piles. And this is the trolley deck giving electricity to the crane for moving the crane. And in that thing, one under the trolley deck, one small pile is there. So, and in between the crane track, we are laying precast concrete blocks, because this is the first construction, so it will undergo settlement. So after some settlement, we can take back this concrete blocks and we can relay it. That is the purpose of that. I think I have covered all the things in this section. This is the dredge level, up to around minus 7.5 dredge level. So you can see that this is a minus 7.5 dredging. We are giving the sheet pail of around 24. So this much embutment is here. You can see the photographs of key wall, not key wall, sheet pile. This is the sheet pile. This sheet pile, this from this log to this log is one sheet pile, and from this log to this log other sheet pile. We can see that, but while driving from this end to this end, we are driving as a whole. That is two numbers we are pairing one, and we are giving, we are driving. Okay. As I told earlier, that this sheet pile having the higher section modulus of 2600 centimeter cube per meter and tensile strength of 550 newton per mm square, yield point stress 460, elongation 17. So these sheet piles we have delivered to Cochin Shipyard by ArcelorMittal Luxembourg. It's a hot rolled sheet pile. Then coming to the, you can see the this properties in after the presentation, you please go through it, so you will understand more. Now coming to how the sheet pail is driving. Sheet pail is can be driven through a standard frequency vibratory hammer, that is a vibro hammer. Vibro hammers reduce, what is the purpose of the vibro hammer? Vibro hammer reduce the friction between the soil and the sheet pile by applying vertical vibrations to the sheet pile. So we have, in our site we have used PTC 60HD heavy duty vibratory hammer. Frequency is having a 1650 RPM and eccentric moment 60 kg meter, maximum centrifugal force 1830 kilonewton. You can see the photographs of vibrate. This is the sheet pile while we delivered to site. This is size preparation for driving the sheet pile. First we are making a trench like this, and then this is the guide frame. This yellow color thing is the guide frame for the sheet pile. So this is the old sheet pile we have driven at 1975. So we searched and found out, and through this lock only other sheet pile is coming. All are through the grooves only sheet pile is driving. So we have to find out the this groove. So we found out the existing old sheet pile, and this is the total 24 meter length sheet pile, and this is all the stiffening bars, flat bars are there for stiffening the double piles. First one sheet pile, this one to this one, and during the from Luxembourg itself it is coming in like that up to here and here to here. So we are driving this pair, then this lock and this lock we are putting. It's a transportation through the crane, then we are fixing the guide frame and vertical guide frame, and through this groove this sheet pile is inserting into the soil. You can see the photographs. This is the existing sheet pile. You can see that after the existing sheet pile, the new sheet pile is driven. This is the existing sheet pile and this is the new sheet pile. You can see that. Then vibro hammer is coming. This is the vibro hammer. And vibro hammer hydraulic oil is going, and a one power pack and a one major unit in the ground. Vibro hammer, you can see it is having two jaws, and through hydraulic oil it is a pressure is giving, then through vibrations the sheet pile is driving. We can see the horizontal guide frame and the vertical guide frame. So you can see the horizontal guide frame, and after align, after driving, this is a driven sheet pile photo. After driving also we have to check the alignment through the total station. Now coming to next item, anchor wall. So sheet pile is over, then anchor wall. Anchor wall, this is the concrete anchor wall. Then I told you for giving the passive resistance, solid stone is filling here and here. And this is the first lift concreting of the anchor wall. This I had depth of around 4.5 meter. These are all the right steps you can see in later. All are the same RCC anchor wall, 25 meter apart from the sheet pile, 170 meter, consisting of seven spans. Seven anchor walls are building. For giving passive resistance, cobblestones are filling. And after the cobblestone filling, we are gunnating with cement mortar with a check-in mesh. You can see the photos, then you will understand better. This is then the anchor wall. This is the tie rod. That is between anchor wall and sheet pile, tie rod is coming, and after that tie rod is covering with a Hessane, bituminous Hessane cloth. This is the cobblestone filling, stone packing up to here, up to here the packing is done. Height base you can see the here. Then chicken mesh is filled here. After the chicken mesh we are gunnating cement mortar 1:3. Then coming to the tie rod. Tie rod is, I told you, between anchor wall and sheet pile, it is a connecting member. So tie rod is laid at a spacing of 1.26. In the section, I have shown that around four pieces connected by ring joint and turnbuckle. In tie rod, tightening was done twice. First at the time of laying, and finally after dredging. Protected by using bitumen impregnated Hessian cloth. Tie rod properties, I'm skipping, you can go through it. Tie rod also delivered to Cochin Shipyard by McCloy UK. This is also an imported thing because of the high grade steel S460N. And mechanical properties, this is a must. Yield point not less than 45 kg per mm square, and tensile strength not less than 61 kg per mm square. We have around 136 numbers of set of tie rod was used for the project. This is the tie rod, some groove you can see that. This is the ring joint, one at the sheet pile side and one at the anchor wall side. In between, at the center, we are giving the turnbuckle. Here is the tightening mechanism is here. So after laying, we are tightening, and after the dredging in front of the sheet pile, then we are again tightening. Then veiling channel that I told you, in front of sheet pile, two ISMC channels are there. Its main function is uniformly distributing the load to the anchor wall. This is the veiling channel. Throughout length, we are giving the veiling channel one number, and the bottom also two number, and it's connected with a splice plate. Now whole thing is coming. Sheet pile, veiling channel, tie rod, anchor wall, and now key construction is over. But above the sheet pile, one coping beam is also there. Then only the sheet pile construction is over. This RCC piles is not for the sheet pile construction. It is for the crane track construction. If crane track construction is not there, when we are not using this RCC pile, only anchor wall, sheet pile, veiling channel, and tie rod and coping beam. It's only requirement. So moving to the coping beam. Coping beam is also a 3 meter height. It is also casting was done in two stages. First 1.5 meter first level concreting, then after the tie rod tightening and after the dredging, only second stage concreting is done. We can see the photographs. Sheet pile, the reinforcement is welding. Then you can see the main thing view, please note that this is the sheet pile and this is the reinforcement is welding to the coping beam, another reinforcement. So a monolithic construction is happening, and all the embedments while concreting the coping beam, all the hardware embedments we have to install. Please remember that this is the first lift con. I told you about the fender placing in front of the key wall. So this is the hardware embedment for the fender. This is the drainage pipes from the earth, from our area to the water is flowing to the water side, back water. The water is flowing through this PVC pipes. So hardware embedments and all those things we have to insert before concreting. And this is the coping beam after first lift concrete. Now coping beam after first lift concreting and dredging. Now bit and bollard placed inside the coping beam for second lift concrete. Before second lift, all the embedments, that this is the bollard, 10-10 bollard. 10-10 bollard we are placing in the coping beam itself. You can see that. And this is the higher bollard, 50-ton or 100-ton. This is resting on the piles. So we can see the coping beam here. This shutter is for the coping beam. And from the coping beam, this bollard is coming in a trapezium shape. Under this is a trapezium shape. Then coping beam is the fine after concreting final 3 meter height coping beam. You can see here. Fender is placed after the embedments, then fender is placed here. This is a super arch fender. This is 600 mm is the projection. Here is around 2.5 meter length. Then coming to the bollards. Bollards are 100-ton bollard, 50-ton bollard and 10-ton bollard. What is the design requirement of the bollard is horizontal load on the bollard due to mooring is designed to be. Main bollard is taking the horizontal load, is tying up. So this horizontal load is designed to be transmitted to the tie rod of sheet pile through concrete of bollard foundation, and vertical load upward is designed to be resisted with the dead weight of the bit foundation. That's why bit foundation is having a good concrete depth around 3 meter. So dead weight is taking the vertical load upward. As I told, 500 ton, 100 ton and 50 ton is resting on piles, 10 ton is on the coping beam. This bit is also IS-26 grade B that is normally available in India. The other thing is that after constructing the bit, we are filling inside also concrete after 15 days. You can see that this is the bollard. We are welding this one in two joints, and we are checking the die penetration test here. And this is the erection photo of the bollard. And the bollard is erected after this concreting. Then after 15 days, we are filling the concrete into it. Then after that, this top is welded. This cover plate is welded. Now coming to the fenders. Super arch type rubber fender of size 600 mm height, depth and 2.5 meter length, and vertical fender 2 meter length. Main rubber body is the synthetic rubber fortified with carbon black, having sufficient resistance against aging, brine, oil and abrasion. Total fender used, I think around 34 and 17. This is the fender after installation. Horizontal fender, this one, two numbers. Vertical is the one fender around 2 meter. Coming to RCC piling. RCC piling is mainly for the crane track. RCC piling cast board cast in situ piles. 650 mm and 500 mm. We have used 271 numbers of piles, which is having the bearing capacity equivalent to N value not less than 50, because more than 50 N value we have taken as the pile bore bottom. Steps in the we have taken direct mud circulation DMC piling in this work. So these are the steps that you are knowing. In the pictorial representation, I will explain. First one is the step one liner, then after liner driving to a some depth, then boring is continued up to the bottom with the help of a bentonite solution to prevent the collapse of the earth. Then after completing the boring to the required level, then what we have done is that after SPT test is done and using the sounding equipment, sounding depth also taken. I think all might have seen the construction site for the, and you have seen the piling works also. So you just recollect all these things what you have seen in, during the earlier days. After the sound, after the boring, we are introducing the steel reinforcement. In steel reinforcement, different length and in between, we are lapping is to be there. And after reinforcement driving, then tremie pipe is to be placed here. And tremie place, please note that the this clear gap between the tremie pipe and the pile bottom is at least 200 mm, not more than 300 mm. What is the purpose of this giving this clear gap is that the while concrete is pouring through this funnel, funnel is having 0.5 mq capacity, 1 mq capacity like that. Then while pouring concrete through this funnel up to the end, then if clear gap is there, then concrete is flowing to here. Because of the heavy density of the concrete, it pushes the bentonite slurry up. Likewise, concrete is filled here. And full area concrete is filled. We have used M30 mix and a pile ton of 150 ton excluding friction. We have considered as end bearing alone, and we have done a cyclic pile load test of maximum load of 210, and we got a settlement of around 2 to 3 mm. Now you can see the photos of RCC piles ready for chipping. After piling around at least 1 meter, we have to chip because in the top bad concrete is coming. So a normal procedure is chipping 1 meter height. This is the chipped portion. You can see the tie rod chipped portion. Now coming to crane beam. Here you please note that crane beam means in above the crane beam, crane rail is there and crane is moving on there. So working load is coming. So function of each pile is like a spring, that is elastic foundation. Crane beam is assumed to be a beam on elastic foundation or beam on elastic support. And beam have joints every 25 meter connected by hinge. CR100 rail we have used, that is 88 kg per meter. The rails are fastened to the beams by rail clips and synthetic rubber pad inserted between rail and beam. That I can show the photos so you can understand more better. After tie rod laying, this is the pile chip portion. Then we are giving a sand filling. After sand filling, the PCC then the reinforcement you can see reinforcement we are giving. After the reinforcement, before concreting, a salt plate is to be placed. This is the salt plate. You can see the salt plate. I will show the enlarged view. The salt plate. Then through that holes, nylon cased steel coil. Then this is the stud bolt. The stud bolt is inserted into the nylon cased steel coil like this. Then this is the rail clip. Then whole assembly you can see. Then salt plate, nylon cased steel coil, stud bolt, washer, nut, then rail clip. And you can see this is the portion embedded inside the concrete. You can see the rail fastening assembly, final rail fastening assembly. This is the final thing. Final after casting. Then coming to the trolley deck, electrical power cables for trains are taken along the trolley deck. This is the trolley deck. This electrical power lines through this duct we are taking to the crane. This is the photo. After giving, we are covering this fully. Service trenches also. I told that two service trench, one for gas and other thing, one service trench and one cable trenches. You can see the pipe service trench and the cable trench. After this is the civil construction only over. After that, we are embedding. We are inserting some pipes in two or three layers. Through lines, through pipes, we are inserting water and industrial gases like that. Here, cables are laid here. And after that, this checkered plate covering is there. Now, coming to the pavement work. Pavement means area between the crane tracks and crane rail are paved using precast concrete blocks. That is the precast concrete, I told you, we have done the precast concrete blocks. That it will go anyway, it will go the to settlement because it's the initial construction. So after this precast laying and in between the bitumen sand mix is placed, after that, after a long or a five years, again if it is settled, then we can take up and take these blocks up and again relay. Last around anodes. Anodes is preventing corrosion. We are placing two anodes. It's the aluminium alloy anode. And coming to the dredging, you are interested in having a scene of a dredger. Grab dredger we have used. This is the grab dredger, dredging platform dredger. One platform dredger is there. This grab is doing the dredging. And one barge is there. In that barge, this material is dumped. These materials, we finally moving to the specified dumping point at the port trust. We can't dump into the sea. In the designated dump yard only we can do. So what are the steps in the construction? After the presentation, you please go through it. What are the steps? Excavation, casting of anchor wall, RCC piling like that is just going. What we have adopted, these steps we have adopted. Not this is the clear cut steps for the key wall, but we have adopted this. Why we have adopted this? This means driving of sheet pile is at the fourth point. We can also do at the first point driving. That is sheet pile driving and anchor wall we can do it as a parallel activity. But why we didn't do this? That sheet pile is imported from Luxembourg, so it will take time for the delivery of the material. So at that time we can do the construction of anchor wall, because anchor wall is a concrete construction. These are the volume of major items executed. This volume of major items executed, you can go through it after the seminar. Quality control measures adopted. Quality control measures, site laboratory we have set. And one thing you have to note, that all materials other than cement aggregate rebars were got approved and stamped by classification societies. This classification society, we entered into it, and instead after getting the MTC, this MTC is reviewed by classification society. Then only we can able to drive, because sheet pile, tie rod, all are important things, and all structural materials also this classification society's presence is there. They after checking the MTC, they again review and certified and stamped in the MTC. The in situ standard penetration test also conducted. These are the tests we have done during the project. What are the test description and what is the frequency of the test? All those things you can check. Then now coming to the interesting topic, that is, what are the challenges or issues faced in the project? That you might, you please, these are all the learning lessons, so you also please concentrate into that. So this will help in that your future execution works. This will help in. First challenge we have found is that selection of experienced contractor who have undertaken sheet piling works was very difficult. So during the first tendering, we have given an option that experienced contractor who have undertaken sheet pile works within the last 10 years, but we didn't get any contractor. During the pre-qualification, all contractors got. So we retendered with relaxing a specification that experienced contractor who have undertaken sheet piling work at any point of time. Because sheet piling work, as I told, once in a blue moon it is a happening. So within 10 years, one sheet piling work or one key wall work or one wharf work is not a common thing. So we relaxed this at any, we relaxed in the manner that at any point of time we included. So we got four bidders and we have awarded to the lowest bidder. Next thing is that period of work during the pre-bid meeting, some prospective bidders raised the issue that period of completion of 18 months to be is inadequate. But due to the urgency requirement of berthing the indigenous aircraft carrier to this area, we need key space. So we were not in a position to extend the 18 months, but we completed within 20 months. During the execution stage, first we observed is that collapse of shoring bar strutting due to the seepage of water during the excavation of anchor bar. This is the during the excavation time, this sheet pile is collapsed. So what we done is additional props given for proper shoring. You can see the additional props given for the proper shoring. Then after giving the additional props, everything is settled. Next thing we faced is that difficulty in interlocking the first new sheet pile to the existing old sheet pile due to the change in the shape of interlock. That is, this is the existing AZ sheet pile and this is the new AZ sheet pile. This is the old 1975 the Nippon steel sheet pile. This is the ArcelorMittal sheet pile. So what is happening is that this lock and this lock is not matching. I told you in the we have to interlock to the existing sheet pile, then only interlocking is affecting, then sheet pile work is able to work. So how we modified is that we have given a flat bar here and we have given a flat bar here, and in between and welded to this, we cut the interlock of this sheet pile, and this sheet pile already there, we cut the interlock and then we placed a flat bar, and then here it is welded. You can see the enlarged view. Concrete filled in between the existing sheet pile and flat bar to a depth of 7.5 meter to make impervious bar. That is, flat bar cut from the new sheet pile, welded to the first sheet pile and to form a reformed pile. So this making is known as reformed sheet pile making. In the third thing, what we faced is the necking of pile. Necking of pile means while driving up to boring around 40 meter, we are not able to drive further. Then we increase the specific gravity of bentonite slurry, and then again reboring was done. So we somehow managed the boring to the required level. But while next step, while reinforcement lowering up to 40 meter, again this not able to driven further, then again this soft clay formation is there. This soft clay formation is known as necking of pipe. So some this area, some areas we are not able to clear this necking. So at that time we find this up to this area we terminate the borehole, and then what we done is that we fill the sand up to here, full up to this bore depth. We fill the sand, and then concreting is terminated up to here. Then water loss while driving the RCC pipe is the next point. Says the casing provided in it. In some of the piles driven at the extreme land say, I told you that crane track is in the 100 meter of crane track is in the existing key wall. So in the existing key wall already cobblestone fillings are there. The new key wall, after driving the pile only we have done the cobblestone filling and granating all those things. But in the existing filling key wall already this cobblestone filling and old anchor wall everything is there. So already tie rod also there. So pile spacing is between two tie rods. The pile we have driven. So what happened is that water loss is happening, but that is bentonite slurry pumped was not recirculating due to the seepage of slurry through the cobblestone filling of the anchor wall. So preventing this, what we decided is that we given permanent MS casing up to the cobblestone level, that is up to 6 meter. We have given permanent casing. Then this issue was tackled. Next thing is that one building foundation was encountered while driving the RCC pipe. Then after encountering this old foundation, this was finally demolished and then we done the pipe. Delay in the receipt of sheet pile. That is why I am telling that sheet pile driving is new. If we are giving as the first item, then sheet pile receipt of sheet pile is the problem. We have also ordered and delivered during July, but it was held up at Mumbai port for 3 months due to the delay in getting permission from Director General of Shipping to ship the sheet piles to Cochin due to the monsoon issue during the July. At that time heavy monsoon is there, so 3 months delay happened. So we completed the work from the 18 months program. We completed within the 21 months we completed the program. So now I conclude my presentation. I am aware that this 1 hour session is not sufficient for deliberately telling all the aspects of marine construction. But since I am running fast through the slides, some of you might not have thoroughly understand all the aspects. You don't worry, because these all projects are once in a blue moon. It is a happening. As I told, it is a unique projects. So you got some familiarization in the jargons like a fenter, boy, alloys, anodes, sheet pile, tie rod, anchor wall, and the construction methodology of the key wall construction materials and construction equipment, that vibro hammer. You will not come across in the normal civil engineering sites. So this will definitely help you in the future interviews and in your future developments. And we are taking up 2 major projects in Cochin Shipyard. If you are interested, someone can visit our site, so you will get more idea. I wish you all a good luck and best wishes for your future. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request, I also introduce Mr. Matthews Abraham, who is a Deputy General Manager of Infra Projects Department, Cochin Shipyard Limited, to join the session, because both of them have worked together for this work. Matthew sir, please.
Yeah, thank you, Divya. It was a wonderful presentation. And the effort by team VIT is really appreciable. because in this lockdown period, this type of information passing on to the students is well appreciated. And these type of presentation, even if you see this marine thing, it's never, it's not a continuous construction process. It's once in a blue moon, you get the opportunity to see all those things. And this project we have constructed during 2013 in a span of 18 months. And that too leads to a lot of difficulties. And now when we are delivering this type of presentation to the new generation, it's a thought-provoking thing to them, because they don't see or they don't study all those things in their regular curriculum. So this type of relations, maybe a cooperation between the academia and these professional industrial bodies are really appreciable. So it was a really thought-provoking the presentation, and we are all open to questions. Little civil engineers can grooming civil engineers can ask questions. We are open to questions now. All your doubts can be cleared.
Okay, moving on to Sandra. Please handle the question answer session. Sandra, are you there? Sandra.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Please ask the questions.
Thank you, Danya ma'am, to give a wonderful section. Let us move on to the question answer section, ma'am. First question is, generally, bentonite we recycle by comparing the used bentonite's physical and chemical properties with the fresh bentonite.
Can you repeat once more? Generally, bentonite solution is?
Generally, bentonite we recycle by comparing the used bentonite's physical and chemical properties with the fresh bentonite.
Yeah. Normally, this bentonite solution is circulating with the existing bentonite, and we are checking every time. We are checking the viscosity using the marked. Using the some viscosity hydrometer is there, and we are checking all the components of the bentonite, and if it is okay, then within the limits, then only we are ready to recirculate the thing.
Okay, ma'am. Next question is, what is the use of SSP piles?
Sheet pile. SSP means steel sheet pile. Sheet. What is the use of sheet SSP? Am I clear? Right.
SSP piles.
SSP piles means steel sheet pile. Steel sheet pile, as I told, this is a what is the use means mainly retaining wall or dry dock construction sheet pile. That is for making a retaining wall. The sheet pile is the main requirement. If the sheet pile is not there, then when we can use a diaphragm wall like that. For the retaining wall purpose, we are using that sheet pile.
Okay, ma'am. Next question is, what is the upcoming project in shipyard?
Upcoming project means that right now we are taking up two major expansion projects. Right now, the shipyard area is fully exhausted. That's why we are telling geographical expansion to moving to other areas all over India. Right now, we are taking up these two major projects, that is new dry dock project and a shipyard project. That is going on in a good pace.
Okay, ma'am. Next question is, how do you track water coming out while piling? How do you tackle water coming out while piling? I mean to say, it's near to water body, so huge amount of water seepage must be there.
Okay, that is. Normally bentonite is using in the, if it is a sandy area, then we are going for bentonite. And it is a clayey area, in our new dry dock construction, we are using the polymer. Then water seepage is there. For that, if huge water seepage is there, then we are using the casings. That is, the permanent casings we have to use for up to the water seepage level. If it is, if we are not using
normally we are using anyway, we are temporary casing also we are using, and after the concreting we are taking up the temporary casing. This temporary casing normally up to 11 meter we can use and take back, no issue. If a higher water is there in this, in the this is a water body area, then also right now it is in the land and we are having a water table of 1 meter below, but anyway using the temporary casing itself we can able to manage that. After the concrete take the temporary casing.
Okay ma'am.
Yes, I would like to add on that. Piling in waters is not an issue. Because if you see the jetty structures are all standing on the piles. So while doing that pile, we will have to drive the casing as a permanent thing, as Dania told. So that will be a sacrificial thing. It will be crowded over a period of time. But doing a piling in waters is not an issue. We'll have to drive, the water column will be around, we are driving the maybe casing for our current project, we are driving the casing. The depth of even 20 meter and the pile depth is 40 meter. The half of depth we are driving. So what water column is there in the that 20 meter case is 10 meter water column is there. So in order to withstand that pressure and all those things, we are driving the casing to up to a meter of 20 meter. So that is not an issue. Wherever waters are on high sea also we can do this type of piling. No issues. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Next question is, what is the grade of concrete is pouring in pile construction in marine?
That normally we have done in M30. In key wall construction, we have done in M30. But right now, this is a minimum as per IS code, IS 2911, minimum grade is M30. But in the dry dock construction, we are doing it in M45. And ship lift also, I think M45.
That also I would like to add, the thing is that it depends upon the design life of the structure. You all know the design structure of normal civil construction is 50 years, but the thing is that our dry dock has been designed for a design life of 100 years. So depends upon the design life, the grade of concrete also will go. Minimum requirement is M30 for pile in marine thing, but we are using M45 since our structures are designed for 100 years lifetime. Okay, hope you understood.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Next question is, difference of anchor wall and Q wall.
Can you repeat?
Difference between anchor wall and Q wall.
Difference between anchor wall and key wall, that is anchor wall is a concrete, it's a dead man, that is anchoring the sheet pile load using the tie rod. This anchor wall is anchoring, so design is like that. You can use same material for the anchor wall also, no issue, because this sheet pile in some Vallarpadam project, the anchor wall is also made up of the sheet pile. That is, this key wall section is having the higher section more or less thing, and the anchor wall section having the lower section more or less. Due to the economical thing, we have gone with the concrete anchor wall.
Okay, ma'am. Next question. Ma'am, can you share your experience in coffer dam construction?
I forgot to tell about the cofferdam construction. That is for a dry dock. During the dry dock explanation, I forgot to tell that. That is dry dock, a main ingredient is the cofferdam construction. And the ship lift project, no cofferdam. That is the main achievement. This cofferdam, dry dock is having a span of 3 years or 4 years. Up to 4 years, this cofferdam also to be there. So cofferdam construction, that is also mainly of sheet pile thing. Sheet pile, normally we are using with the sheet piles only, is the cofferdam. And after the cofferdam construction through water, same vibrohammer, using the same vibrohammer, we can drive the cofferdam. Some things required is that one barge is required and one crane. Of crane should to be molded on the barge. Then through that.
Thank you, ma'am. The next question is, Why only bentonite is used during construction? Is there any other material which have same properties as bentonite?
Yes, same property as I told is polymer, but polymer comparing to bentonite is costlier. But polymer, in advantage of polymer is that the disposal, for the disposal of polymer, no issue. It is a user eco-friendly and user eco-friendly thing. So we can, this polymer is mixed with the sand, mixed with the clay, and it can be dumped as a clay dumping. But it is a bentonite, then it is only a solution. This solution is feeding to a closed container, closed jeep, lorry, and then only we can able to dispose. Disposal of bentonite is a problem. That's why polymer is a if polymer is a clay area, based on the soil condition only we can able to use the we can able to select the bentonite or polymer. Costlier, polymer is costlier, but polymer is used in the sand, then it has problem.
Okay, ma'am. Next question is, what is the method of design is used in RCC structure in marine structure, ma'am?
Method of design means which one you are asking about, the STAD software or any principle, that principle of design. I will tell you the briefly. I will tell you the as a general, the method of design for the key wall, we have taken that in 1969, it is set up in collaboration with Mitsubishi Japan. I told you at that time Japan design was there, Japanese design. In that design, that is a normal software. That design, same design we adopted in the thing only, in the new extension also. That is the main anchoring, that is water pressure, earth pressure, so stability check, all those things. That is the same design we are doing.
I would like to add on that. Actually, a lot of quotes are available. Even our all the projects like coming at Trido project, they all did done with respect to Euro quotes. Because in the right construction, caudal provisions for Indian standards are there are caudal things, but it's limited. But basically, all the things are designed based on Euro quotes. Indian courts are now relevant. It's coming up in the marine side also. But we are almost in the new construction, we are following the Euro courts, because Euro courts are more economical also. For huge projects, this economy also has to be taken care based on the design life also, because these are all our expansion is to the tune of around 300 crores of rupees. 3,000 crores of rupees. So we will have to have economics the design also. So mainly we are going to Euro codes. Euro codes, the things are that's a factor of safety, everything has not to, in Indian standards is 2.5, but Euro codes they are telling it's 1.5 or 1. But the thing is that quality has to be stringent. That is why. So the quality aspects, everything has to be very stringently monitored if you are using the Euro code thing. Hope that clarifies the things.
Sandra?
Ma'am, the next question is, why is hammer piling method preferred over all other valuable construction conventional method?
Which one? Why is hammer? Can you repeat one more time?
Why is hammer piling method preferred over all other available conventional methods?
Hammer piling means hammer piling, the DMC, you are asking about the sheet piling or RCC piling? Which piling you are asking? Piling or sheet? RCC piling, or I will tell you both. In the hammer piling means vibro hammer, you are asking, I think so, for the sheet pile. So for the sheet pile, vibro hammer driving is the most preferred method, because the sheet pile driving mainly everywhere we are using the vibro hammer. In some areas vibro hammer is not going, then we are doing the impact hammer driving. Impact hammer having a good great sound. Vibro hammer is having some vibrations, but we are doing at site in with all the limitations, because within the limited value only we are doing. So normally vibro hammer is the accepted practice for driving the sheet pile. Apart from vibro hammer, if it is not moving, then impact hammer also can be done.
Okay. Yeah. The next question is, do these marine infrastructures are capable of withstanding the seismic loads?
Yes. We have designed the thing for the seismic loads also. So seismic analysis is done. So due to the seismic analysis only, also we are designing through the designing load, the steel reinforcement is coming great high. This is definitely withstanding the seismic loads.
Okay, ma'am. Next question is, which grade of steel reinforced bar can be used in here?
In QE, in key. That is normal grade FE500 we have used in the key also. Right now also, in the dock also, we are using the FE500 grade. Yeah.
What are the corrosion inhibiting admixtures are added to the RCC in these marine structures to resist the chloride diffusion?
Some corrosion inhibitors are there. I am not remembering the right name. Some BASFs and the Fostroc also corrosion inhibitors are there. But right now we are in our dry dock project also. We are not using the corrosion inhibitors, but we are preventing the corrosion by providing the anode. In the key wall, we are using the sacrificial anodes. Sacrificial anodes is for preventing corrosion to the steel sheet pile. And the RCC pile also fully covered for preventing corrosion. We are in marine structures, we are giving a cover of 100 mm. Like that, corrosion inhibitor is there, but we are not. That is based on the choice of the designers, whether it is added or not.
The steel used in marine structures. Hello?
It is not audible. Yeah.
Which of the steel in marine structure?
Which of the steel
used in the marine structure?
That which of the steel means, right now it's muted, right now it's okay. So which of the steel means we have used as Vaishak, that is during the tender itself, we have given the approved brands. So Vaishak, the SAIL and the JSW and four brands we have given. And that steel only contractor has to purchase. These brands we have used and grade is FE500.
Okay, ma'am. Next question is, how much rate is estimated in marine structure like anchor wall or pile structure?
How much? Which one? How much?
How much rate is estimated in marine structure like anchor wall and pile structure?
That rate, we are not in a position to disclose all those things. But rate is a high rate. Anchor wall, it is a concrete. It's a concrete wall. So normally in the civil construction, what is the concrete wall? That's the same rate is adopted. Sheet pile, I think it is based on the section modulus of the thing, the rate is vary.
Okay. Okay, ma'am. Next question is, What's the important instruction for civil engineer build-up?
What is the important instruction of civil engineer?
Build-up.
I didn't get that. Meghmathu sir, can you answer that?
Yeah, you just repeat that question. I am not clear. It's not clear to me.
What is the important instruction for civil engineer build-up?
Civil engineer build-up?
Yeah.
That means advice to us coming up civil engineer. Can you repeat that question? What is the
important instruction for a civil engineer build-up?
Instruction, I don't understand that question.
We are not understanding.
Can you repeat that?
Excuse me, Sandra, who has asked this question? Please unmute yourself and you can please ask.
Anil Kumar.
Anil Kumar, can you please unmute yourself and please ask? Is Anil Kumar there? The question is not clear, that's why.
Ma'am, move on to next question.
Yes, Sandra, you can move on.
Which band and what grade of cement is used in marine structure?
The grade of cement is normally we are using in the dry dock construction we are used Ambuja cement PPC we have used, but in the marine construction we are using right now in the dry dock construction that OPC plus GGBS, that is combining OPC and GGBS we are using, and PPC also we are using, both we are using.
Now the best I will add on to that, the best part of us, the best cement to be used for marine construction is blended cement. You may be aware that blended cement with PPC is there, Portland slag cement is there. So normal OPC blended with fly ash or silica, all these come all blended cements. So that will be more suitable for a marine structures to protect it from corrosion. But in our one of our projects, right, recent project also, we are faced with a problem of chloride as well as sulfate. Sulfate was also there, chloride also was there. So we were forced to use OPC cement because in OPC cement, C3A content, trisilicate, aluminum was, it has to be more, if the contents of soil is more containing chloride as well as sulfate, we have to use a cement with C3A content greater than 5. That is why we have gone for OPC. OPC only having C3A content greater than 5. So normally marine construction blended cement is suitable.
Thank you, sir. Next question is, for construction of marine structure, we need all skilled labor or shall we use unskilled labor?
We need a skilled labor because in a marine construction, in a major infrastructure project, skilled labor and unskilled labor both are there. There is some proportion is there. But in the sheet pile driving and RCC piling, normally in the sheet pile driving, in all are to be skilled laborers. And all unskilled and skilled are there, but most good increase in the proportion is there in the skilled. Is skilled labor.
Okay, ma'am. What is the maximum life of SSP pile?
SSP pile means that Mathis sir already told the design life. The design while designing a building, design by life we have done. The design life is that for the dry dock it is 100 years. Key wall also because in the existing key wall we made in 1975, and right now it is around 50 years is going on. So I think design life is the main criteria for that. So design life is 50 years, is 100 like that. It's going on.
Okay,
I would like to add on that, to increase the life of the sheet pile, you need to do some protections. Like in dry dock, we are painting the sheet pile. For the other thing, in addition to painting, we are also having this cathodic protection. That is, this cathodic protection is in the presentation, it was shown as anodes. So they instead of when the saline water comes, marine water comes in touch with the steel part, only the anodes will disintegrate, not the steel part. So we keep on changing the anodes on a frequency of around 5 years, so that this anodes will get eaten up, not the steel. So the steel part will remain there without any corrosion.
Hope you can clear this. Mainly the sacrificial anode can be replaced within a 5 years period, then this sheet pile design can be that's why around 50 years we are keeping the sheet pile with no issues.
Okay ma'am, move on to next question.
Okay.
Can we use any type of concrete in construction of marine structures?
Can we use any type of concrete in the type of any type of concrete means marine, any grade means minimum M30 grade and from M30 to upward. Any type means I didn't get that.
I think that question already answered previously. It was answered that grade of concrete, everything we discussed. You can go
okay, then we can move to the other question.
What is the slum value is acceptable in marine structure? Ma'am? Hello? Hello?
Can you repeat that?
Yeah. Hello, ma'am. Can you hear me?
No. Right now he is hearing. But question I didn't heard that Sandra's question.
What is the slum value is acceptable?
Voice is cutting. The slum value is?
Slum value is acceptable in marine structures.
Slum value is acceptable in marine structures. Higher slum value you are asking about?
You tell the slum. You tell the slum of pile and other structures. You tell that.
Ma'am, Nasir. Ma'am.
Yeah, if slum value, you know, normal slum value of 85 like that, and up to pile up to increase about 140 also, no issue. But we can increase the slum value because as Mathisa told, that blended concrete we are using. So that is OPC plus GGBS or OPC plus like PPC, OPC plus fly ash like that. So we can increase the slum value also. The Euro code is permitting. Because it is a pump, it is in the RMC plant, batching plant we are doing. So some slum value increase also, apart from the IS code, Euro code is permitting some increase in the values.
Okay, ma'am. Next question is, reasons behind using... Okay, ma'am. Next question is, reasons behind using of green color bars in some marine construction. Ma'am, that is clear?
Yeah, question is clear. That is green color bars means I think after the reinforcement laying, we are painting with a corrosion inhibitor painting. That is the green color bar. You are seeing that. No, the reinforcement with painting some corrosion inhibitors. For preventing the corrosion.
Okay, ma'am.
Those are some epoxy coated paints. Naturally, now normally when the duration of the casting, maybe the reinforcement laying and the casting of the concretes get delayed, normally they will apply some epoxy coated protective paints. But nowadays that are not, because the construction sequence is because after laying of the reinforcement, maybe within a couple of days we will be concreting. So in that case, that is not required. So what is that green thing is the epoxy coated protective paint.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Next question is, why not using in self-compacting concrete in marine structure?
That is question normally is marine structures. Question is clear. Normally, marine structure we are using that we are adding the batching plant and we are using the cast in situ concrete and normally precast concrete, self-compacting concrete we are normally use, not normally using. Mathi sir, can you please add on it?
No, self-compacting, to my understanding, it is used for maybe the inaccessible area or where we cannot use the vibrator as well. But marine structures, we are limiting.
Mathi sir, can you please add on it? Anything is there?
I am adding. So that is the case in the we, what we are doing is that in normal marine construction if you leave aside the pile, all the other things we are doing from the ground only, so it's all accessible and the core is not more than 1.5 meter, so no need of a self-compacting concrete is needed. Even we can compact by manually compact also. So no need of that is required. Even for the piles, we are using a this one concrete with a slump of around 140 or 120 to 140. So it will also get compacted, and with the tremie also we are doing compaction. So the self compacting is not required in marine constructions.
Thank you, sir. We move on to next question. In how much years, ma'am?
Yeah, hearing. Yeah, tell me.
In how much years trenching is done? Were these waste are dumped after collecting? Is trenching affects the basement of QR?
Can you please repeat the question? How much years trenching?
Okay, ma'am.
Could you please repeat once more?
In how much years trenching is done? Were these waste are dumped after collecting? Is trenching affects the basement of QR?
Oh, dredging. You are asking about the dredging. Oh, amen. How much years dredging is done? How much years?
I will answer that.
Yeah.
During the initial stages of construction of a keyhole, we do capital dredging. That is, you have seen that after the coping beam is constructed, we have to do a capital dredging in the waters to have the water depth. So in the over a period of time, when the siltation happens, siltation means settling of some sediments will happen, the water depth will decrease. So in that case, we have to do the maintenance dredging. The frequency of maintenance dredging depends upon the rate of siltation. In Cochin area, we are experiencing a siltation level of around 30 centimeter per month, and it goes increases to 50 even in monsoon. So naturally, we have to do every year some sort of a maintenance dredging in front of our quay to maintain the water depth. Then only ship will be berthed. In another case, if dredging is not done or maintenance dredging is done, ship will be grounded. You see the word grounded. It will be standing, sitting on the soil. So it is got grounded. Ship will be grounded. So the frequency of dredging depends upon the siltation rates. So our frequency is every 1 to 2 years we do this maintenance dredging.
Okay, sir.
Sandra, we limit to two more questions, okay? Because questions are many, we are in running off time also. So we limit to two questions. The rest of the questions will be answered in the WhatsApp group. Is it okay?
Okay, ma'am. Five more questions, ma'am.
Ask two more questions. Rest of the questions we'll answer in the WhatsApp group.
Okay. Next question is, any water repelling cement or like concrete is used in the mix for marine structure construction?
That normal we are already told about the cement, that is OPC plus OPC cement plus GGBS, otherwise PPC cement. Normally pure OPC we are not using normally in the marine structures, and the blended cement already we are using, that Matthew sir told that. Anything to add, Matthew sir?
No, actually for marine construction now water repellent cement is not required. It is high grade concrete is only required to resist the maybe saline condition. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
The last, ma'am, the last question is how we can find the pile is exactly soaked in the rock.
Could you repeat?
I think I will answer that. In Cochin area, we are not socketing into the rock. Piles are not socketed into the rock. Now the thing is that in Cochin area, you will find the rock only after 670 meter only. And our all the piles, we are resting on maybe our pile length is around 40-44 meter, and we are resting almost all the piles on the sand layer. So it is, there is no socketing happening in Cochin area, but there are some areas where socketing also, if you go to Goa, pile socketing, Mumbai, that pile socketing will happen. Pile socketing is done maybe to a minimum of
Kerala, 6 meter, in Kerala 6 meter. Also socketing is not a normal practice. We are normally,
so as I said, in Mumbai area, socketing is happened because of the rock thing, and minimum 2 meter is happened. Then special type of chisel is required. Anyway, this all the piles are driven while maintaining a verticality. So when the vertical auger come goes up, we will have to check the verticality, and the chisel will with the chisel we can know how much we have driven the or taken out the, carved out the rock. So that way we can understand that the pile is socketed into the rock. But in Cochin area, normally all the piles are friction piles or end bearing, in the sense we will be resting on sand. And it is a combined friction and end bearing piles we are doing in Cochin area. Anything to be added?
Hello, Danya ma'am.
Yes.
We wind up the question answers section first. Time limit. Thank you, Danya ma'am and Matthew sir, for this gave a wonderful informative section. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. Yeah. Wish you all the best for your best future.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Matthew sir, for sharing your experience. Now I am moving on to Sri Lakshmi. Sri Lakshmi, can you hear me? Please unmute. Sri Lakshmi, are you there?
Yes. Hello, ma'am.
Okay. You can Hello? Speak, Sri Lakshmi. Yes, it is audible. You can speak.
Hello, I am Sri Lakshmi. Thank you, Danya ma'am, for the wonderful session. It was really helpful for us, and I thank all the participants for their kind attention. Since today is the last day, we will move on to a small validatory. So I invite Ms. Chandana, faculty coordinator of this work.
Good evening, everyone. Hope you all had a wonderful week with us in this past week. We had various sessions by wonderful and eminent speakers. So this workshop, organized in association with ICI Calicut Center, it was actually conducted with a motive to impart the more knowledge about the industrial applications of structural engineering and concrete technology. So it was actually started on 25th, last week, 25th of May. And first 2 days we had sessions on structural engineering by Mahadevan sir and by Engineer Sujisha. Then following 3 days was about concrete and quality management by Engineer Parvati Uni and Dr. Danya ma'am. Then by Shaiju Nai sir. And also then yesterday we had a session on approval of preparation of approval drawing by Samira. Also we had an extra additional session by ICI along with association with Ultratech also about non-destructive test by Engineer Ravi sir. And today on the final day we had a introduction to marine structures by Danya ma'am. And each session conducted was variant, and hope you all had the motive was met and you all had a step ahead on your knowledge. Thank you everyone for your participation and cooperation. Over to you, Sri Lakshmi. Sri Lakshmi,
give a feedback. Yes, thank you ma'am, thank you Chandana ma'am. Hello, I request anybody from the participants to give a feedback.
Participants, anyone you can unmute and speak. Participants, participants, is there no one?
Hello.
Okay, please introduce yourself and speak. It is Shahir Mohammed, right? It's not audible. Can you please raise your voice? It's not audible, sir. Sri Lakshmi, you can move on. Sri Lakshmi, any other participants, can you please give your feedback, because there is having some range issue. Any other participants, can you please unmute yourself?
Nobody.
Anyone? Nobody wishing to speak. Just you can unmute and speak. Okay, you can speak.
Hello,
Akshay, please unmute yourself. Okay, Praneet, you can speak. We'll come to you, Akshay. Praneet, are you there? Or Akshay, can you speak? Is there anyone?
Hello.
Okay, you can speak.
I am Akshay. I am final year student in diploma in civil engineering. I am studying in OPTC Adavana. And this section is a very wonderful experience for me to gain the knowledge about the structural design and about the concrete. Thank you everyone, and respectively Divya ma'am and other coordinators, to make this section a great and good one. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Akshay. Is there anyone else?
Hello?
Yes, Anu, I can hear you. You can speak.
Hello, good evening. I'm Anu, working as an assistant professor in GECBH Barton Hill Government Engineering College. Hello? It's audible?
Yes, it is audible.
Okay, it was a wonderful section by Danya ma'am. I think I gathered some of the information regarding the marine infrastructure. Actually, I done my PG in infrastructure engineering, but I only heard some words regarding a harbor. I don't know about this detailed information. So it's very informative one. Once again, I thank Cochin Shipyard Limited. Thank you, Danya ma'am. That's all. Hello?
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, is there anyone else? Is there anyone else to give your feedbacks about the workshop?
Good evening, ma'am.
Okay, it is Subramanian, right? You can speak.
Yes, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am. It's a very wonderful session. It's more informative and very helpful in these quarantine days, ma'am. It's really help to bridge the gap between the theory and the practice, ma'am. We attended all workshops, which is in all different parts of the civil engineering field, ma'am. Thank you for conducting these workshops, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Now moving on to Sri. Okay, Sri Lakshmi, you can continue.
Okay, let me invite Fijaz, Chairman of Civil Engineering Association, VVIT, to speak a few words. Fijaz.
Okay. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, it is audible.
Okay. Good evening, all. On behalf of the Civil Engineering Association, it's my privilege to speak on this platform. I am happy to be part of coordinating and conducting this workshop on industrial relevance of structural and concrete technology as a part of associate activity along with ICI. We had a lot of renowned speakers sharing their important works, their findings and opinions with us throughout the last week. They were all very much helpful and informative to all of us. This workshop would not have been successful without the heartily helpful minds of our college management, our principal and ICI Calicut Center. I thank them for the perfect logistic support and guidance they has extended to all of us at the workshop. I also extended to my thanks to our beloved HOD, Divya ma'am. She is the positivity that spread from the Department of Civil Engineering from last year onwards, and without her, I don't know the workshop is ended in such a smooth manner. And all other staffs of Civil Engineering Department, also the students of Civil Engineering, especially CEA executive members, for their enormous cooperation in the organization of this event. I also like to thank Anishma, Shriya, Anandu, Arun, Joel, Gobiga, Sri Lakshmi Babu, Vidya, Hafiz, Sandra, and Sri Lakshmi T, who are hosting the section throughout the last week, and also thank our social media supporters, Instagram pages like Civil Practical Knowledge, for supporting us and increases the participants for the workshop. Finally, like all other programs, you are the success of the program. You, the participants, are the foundation of the workshop. I thank each one of you for supporting us at and attending the workshop. Once again, I thank each and everyone for supporting, for your valuable time and patient listening. Thank you.
Thank you, Fijaz. I request Sangeeta ma'am, principal of VVIT, to speak a few words. Hello.
Hello. Yes, Sri Lakshmi, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am, I can hear you.
Okay, fine. So I think all the participants had a very great time for the past 1 week. I'm very sure that they would have got real good practical knowledge other than what they read from the book, because the speakers were sharing their experience. I could attend one or two sessions. I could hear they were sharing their practical experience, what they do in their field. That is what they were sharing. So I think definitely the participants would have gained much knowledge other than what they can get from the textbook. I would like to congratulate the civil department, Divya ma'am, HOD and her team, also the ICA chapter. Without their support, this workshop would not have been this much successful. I can see there were a lot of participants, more than 280 registrations were there. So I think it was a great success, and all the success, it is just by the hard work of civil department. So I congratulate them and thank you for inviting me. Thank you.
Ma'am, can you come to the screen, ma'am?
Thank you, Sangeeta, ma'am.
Photo session, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, I'm there.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Sri Lakshmi, you can continue.
Thank you, Sangeeta, ma'am. Thank you, Sangeeta, ma'am. I request Divya ma'am, HOD of Civil Department, for vote of thanks.
I request Sajid sir to speak a few words first. Sajid sir, are you there? Sajid sir.
Good evening. Hope I am audible.
Yes sir, it's Hello? Audible. Yes sir, it's audible.
Okay, good evening one and all. It's been almost 1 week since we started this workshop, and VVIT has shown such a lot of interest, and all the programs were so successful. Most of the workshops have been attended by around 200 participants. As always, I just want to add about ICI, because there are some new participants also in this workshop today. ICI is one of the leading professional bodies in India, catering to the professional needs and individuals and organization involved in concrete. Indian Concrete Institute was born in 1982, and now it's a strong professional body, having more than 13,000 enrolled members from 42 regional centers. And we are having around 341 organizational members spread across the entire length and breadth of the country. And in Kerala, we are having three centers, one in Cochin, one in Trivandrum, and another one in Calicut. In Calicut, we are having around 150 members from Malappuram to Kasaragod. And the main aim of ICI is to bridge the gap between theory and practice. To meet the objective of ICI, regional centers conduct various varieties of programs like seminar, workshops, conferences, exhibition, etc., both in national and international level. And today was such a wonderful session, because it took me to my college days also, because I have studied a lot of things in this thing, but on that time I was visioning what is this shipyard and all those things. Now it was a wonderful journey to see that is the main objective, to bridge the gap between theory and practice. And I thank Engineer Danya, Senior Manager, Infra Projects Limited, Cochin Shipyard, and also I thank Engineer Matthew Abraham, Deputy General Manager, for accepting the invitation and giving an overview of Cochin Shipyard. Thank you again. And for the students, there are a lot of opportunities to explore that, because in ICI itself, there are a lot of portals available, there are a lot of libraries available, and just ICI cannot handhold you. You have to take your first step to reach the other side of the bridge. This is the bridge to gap between theory and practice, and you have to reach the other side of the bridge. So start visiting sites also, because most of the participants may be in final year students. Final year students, the next year you are going to become a civil engineer. So you have to visit more sites. You have to explore all the opportunities available. And I wish more technical session to follow from Vedavyasa Institute of Technology. And on behalf of ICA Calicut Center, I wish all the success. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Respected principal, Dr. Sankita ma'am, the speaker of today, Engineer Danya KK, Cochin Shipyard Limited, Engineer Sajid Bhaskar, Secretary ICI Calicut Center, and dear participants. Today we have reached the end of the 1 week online national workshop on industrial relevance of structural and concrete technology. Hope you would have got a good idea about the practical knowledge or you have gained practical knowledge regarding the structures and concrete technology. And our main aim was to build the bridge between the theory and practice, and hope we have attained that, not to a full extent, but to a small extent. I hope it was a wonderful session. Now let me come to my official duty of proposing the vote of thanks. First of all, let me thank our chairperson, Srimati Kala ma'am, and our director, Dr. Arun Korot sir, for giving us full support for organizing this workshop. Next, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Next, I would like to thank our beloved principal, Dr. Sankita ma'am, who is a source of support and motivation for all of us for any kind of activities, even if we have any problems, because initially we had many technical difficulties while before the start of the program. Then at that time when I approached her, she said, "We will do it, ma'am, don't worry, we'll do." And she gave full support for us, and thank you so much, ma'am, from the on behalf of Department of Civil Engineering, ma'am. Thank you so much, Sankita ma'am, for inspiring us and for giving us a lot of support in conducting these sessions. Thank you, ma'am. Next, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to all the speakers, starting from Dr. Mahadevan sir, Dean, University of Calicut, Engineer Sujisha, and Engineer Samira from BIM Labs Private Limited, Engineer Shaiju Nair, CEO of DH Academy, Engineer Parvati Unni from SMEC Labs Private Limited, Dr. B.S. Danya, Associate Professor, RIT Kottayam, Engineer Rabish from Ultratex Private Cement Limited, and Engineer Danya, who's a Senior Manager from Cochin Shipyard Private Limited, and also Engineer Matthew Sir, the Deputy General Manager of Cochin Shipyard Limited. And thank you all for spending your precious time in order to disseminate the knowledge to the young budding engineers. Thank you all for giving us such a sessions. Now I would like to thank my co-organizer, Engineer Sajid sir, for actively involving in all the procedures for coordinating this program. Thank you, sir, for coordinating it. Then I would like to thank all the participants, because without your active involvement in this program, because you were actively involving right from the beginning of the day, right from the first day, you were involving a lot by asking good questions, and also hope we have answered most of the questions involving during these sessions. Now I would like to thank, finally not the least, I would like to thank my own team, that my dear teachers, my dear student representatives from the Department of Civil Engineering. If I mention one name, it would not be sufficient. That's why, because the whole team of final year students, teacher, teaching faculties, especially Chandanamas and Bhagyamas, and all other teachers have helped me a lot in organizing this. They were the main support, and the Civil Engineering Association team, that is involving Fijas and all others, Fijas, if I mention, it won't be enough. It would take the whole day. So it would be, and the whole final year SA students have done it, and they were behind me for everything, even for video editing, for each and everything. There were different persons, different students from all the from the civil engineering department, and that strength proved to conduct this workshop. And thank you all, thank you everyone, each and everyone, thank you. Hope you would have got a good exposure. Thank you all, thank you participants. So we are winding it up. We'll be providing the feedback link in the group. Please write your correct name in the feedback, because that will be depicted in your certificate. So please write your proper name in the feedback link. Okay, we'll be providing it in the group, and we'll be sharing other details, certificate details, all in the group. Okay, hope it is a fine session. Hope we'll end the session. If possible, can everyone keep your video on just to take a final photo? If possible. All the participants. She's on to take a final photo. Since it is a lockdown period, we can't take a photo, that's why. Sangeeta ma'am, are you there? Okay, ma'am. Okay, everyone. Thank you all. Thank you all for your support. Thank you. Shall I wind up?
Thank you. Thank you very much for your support, for the conduction of this as an online seminar. I appreciate the introduction speech also. I appreciate Vedavyasa and ICA chapter, Civil Engineering Department and ICA chapter, for conducting this online seminar for the last seven days through various topics in the field of engineering. For the budding engineers, it will be very useful. And in the future interviews also, all the budding engineers can be use of this. So good luck. I wish you all students and all teachers a good luck and for a best future. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Danya, ma'am. Okay, so shall we wind up? If anyone want to speak, you can unmute and speak.
Good afternoon, madam. Hello.
Good afternoon. We can hear you. Please mention you and speak.
Myself Akash Gowda. I am from Karnataka. I am studying my UG in MSRIT. The session was very good, and it stands for us to know the practical field and practical applications of civil engineering when we go outside of our college. What we learned in this session, all the session of the whole week of this workshop, we could have never learned in the academics in our curriculum. It was very useful for me, madam.